black as night, there was no moon inside. You know the stars ain't shining cause the sky's too tight. I heard the scary wind, I seen some ugly trees. There was a werewolf walking along the side of me. I'm mean and I'm bad, you know I ain't no sissy. Got a big chitty girl in by the name of Chrissy. Talking about her in my bike of beef. In the side of the mountain. I noticed even the crickets were acting weird up here. And so I figured I might just drink a little beer. I said, give me some of that, what you're sucking on. But there was no reply, cause she was gone. Where's those titties I like so well? And my goddamn beer is what I started to yell. Then I heard this noise like a crunch of twig. And up jumped the devil, he's about this big. He had a red suit on and a widow's peak. And then a pointed tail and like a sulfur root. Yes, it was him, all right. I swear to God, it was. He had some human flesh up underneath his claws. You know, it looked to me like it was titty skin. I said, you son of a bitch, because I was mad at him. Well, he just got out his floss and started cleaning his fangs. So I shot him with my shooter, said, bang, bang, bang. Then the sucker just laughed and said,
put it away. You know, I ate it all up. Now what you gonna say?
You ate my Chrissy?
Titties and all!
Well, what about the beer then, boy?
The can's this tall!
Even her boots?
Would I lie to you?
Shit, you must have been hungry.
Yes, this is true!
Don't they pay you good for the stuff that you do?
Well, you know, I can't complain when the checks come through.
Well, I want my Chrissy, and I want my beer, so you just barf it back up. Now, devil, do you hear?
Blow it out your ass, motorcycle man! I mean, I am the devil, do you understand? Just what will you give me for your titties and beer? I suppose you noticed this little contract here.
You're goddamn right, you son of a whore.
Don't call me that.
That's about the only reason I learned writing for. Give me that paper, bet your ass I will sign. Because I need a beer and it's titty squeezing time.
Man, you can't fool me. You ain't that bad. I mean, you should have seen some of the souls that I've had. Why,
oh, yeah?
There was Milhouse Nixon and Agnew too. And both of those suckers were worse than you.
Well, let's make a deal if you think that's true. I mean, you're the devil, so what you gonna do?
Wait a minute. A tinge of doubt crosses my mind when you say that you want to make a deal with me.
That's very, very true.
Wait, you ain't supposed to want to make a deal with me.
Ah, but I'm slightly different than your average customer, devil.
But most people don't want to make a deal with me.
Yeah, well, most people are afraid of you. See, they don't know how stupid you are. I happen to know that you jack off to a picture of Puffy Meadows when you get home.
Stupid.
You know, ever since that guy told you that he contained more fluid than Jeff Beck, you've been trying to outdo him. Well, look, I'm going to say one thing to you. This may not register right away, but let me say this. Leave your pickle alone for a couple of nights, you know what I mean? Now, come on. I'm only interested in a couple of things. Wait, is that a note for me? Is somebody passing me a note? What is this? Frank, please do me a favor. I can't find a brother of mine. I could dig it if you could call him from stage. His name is Dirty Tom Nomads MC. Signed, thanks. Bear or Bean? I can't tell. Well, if he's out there, Dirty Tony, D-Law Nomads.